Good morning, honkers.
I'm Natalie.
I'm Abby.
And I'm Ruby.
And this is your honker news.
No school Friday, March 11th. So if you come to school, no one will be here. So just go home.
Sports. JV Varsity Boys Volleyball versus River Valley RV at 5 to 6 p.m. JV Varsity Swim and Dive versus River Valley and Roseville at Gap at 4 p.m.
Announcements. Senior grad night will be after graduation on June 2nd. Tickets will go on sale March 12th for $50. You can Venmo to at Taryn-Hernandez-2 or drop off your payment with Carrie Spencer in the principal's office. If you pay by Venmo, include your first name and student ID. First 50 students that purchase tickets will be entered in a drawing for a door prize.
Seniors, if you're planning on attending Yuba College in the fall and want early registration, please sign up for Yuba College Quick Reg by March 25th. Please check your counselor's Google Classroom for all the info and links. Don't forget, you can still do FAFSA through June 2023.
The Honker Hustle. The gold cart is here. Look for the gold cart at lunch and bring your Honker Hustle passes for a treat. The cart will be out Thursday, March 10th. Stay gold!
Students, do you need a summer job? The Sutter Pool is offering jobs as lifeguards, swim instructors, and office staffs. Applications are available in the principal's office and will be due on March 10th. And here's this week's student spotlight.
My name is Elijah Perez. I'm 15 years old and I'm a sophomore. Normally in my free time, I like to just play some games with my friends, family, like Mario Kart and stuff like that. Actually, I am able to solve a Rubik's Cube in about 20 seconds or less. Speed cubing for a little under a year now. I started back in 2021 March. I was 14 going to turn 15. So for anyone who wants to start, I would say learn more things when you're starting off, because over time, once you start cubing, you start developing habits, whether it be good habits or bad habits. But if you practice for a long time with those bad habits, then it's going to hurt you in the long run. So learn good habits when you're first starting out so that you can stick with them forever. Yeah, my personal best happened in around December of last year, and it was a 9.83 second solve. I was very lucky. Anything that I would like to say, I would recommend everyone to try solving Rubik's Cube. It's really not that hard. All I had to do was get an actual Rubik's Cube, and then I just went online to a YouTube tutorial, followed along with it, and as long as you're in the mindset of I can do this, you will most likely be able to solve it, because a lot of people go into it thinking that they can, and then once they realize, they get discouraged and then they stop.
After school detention will be held Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday in the Gold Room from 3:15 to 4:15 p.m. If you can't attend, please come to the admin office to reschedule.
Math Month. The Math Department welcomes you to Math Month, which is February 7th through March 14th. February 7th represents Euler's number E, and March 14th represents Pi.
Today's math quote: mathematics may not teach us to add, love, or subtract hate, but gives us hope that every problem has a solution.
Cap and gown. If you plan to borrow a cap and gown for the graduation ceremony, please fill out the link that was sent to your email. The deadline for the form is March 15th.
Yearbooks are available for purchase online. Order yours today before prices increase.
Ceramics Club is selling St. Patrick goodie bags at lunch by the food truck. You can get a handmade ceramics ornament for only $3 on March 14th, 15th, and 17th.
And here's a new segment, Nerd News with Michaela.
Welcome to Nerd News. I'm Michaela, and I'll be your host this week, where we'll take a look at the newest and best pieces of nerdy media and bring it hot and fresh to you, our viewers. This week, we'll be taking a quick look at Amazon Original, The Lord of the Rings, Rings of Power. So grab your sword and wizard staff, because we are going on an adventure.
Three rings for the elven kings under the sky. Seven for the dwarf lords in their halls of stone. Nine for mortal men doomed to die. One for the Dark Lord on his dark throne. In the land of Mordor, where the shadows lie.
Fun fact, none of that was CGI. It was all done by hand. Scheduled to release its first episode on September 2nd, 2022, with celebrity stars like Robert Armaio as Elrond, Morfrid Clark as Galadriel, and Sophia Namvrit as Disa. This will not be a show to miss. Developed by J.D. Payne and Patrick McKay, Rings of Power is set thousands of years before the event of The Hobbit and The Lord of the Rings. The series is based on author J.R.R. Tolkien's History of Middle-earth, begins during a time of relative peace, and covers all the major events of Middle-earth's Second Age: the forging of the Rings of Power, the rise of the Dark Lord Sauron, the fall of the island kingdom of Numenor, and the last alliance between the elves and men. These events take place over thousands of years in Tolkien's original series, but are condensed for the series. Well, that's all the time we have for our nerd news, so back to you, honkers.
Art Club has a meeting today at lunch in room 802. There's plans for Solidarity Week and food fair next month, so make sure you show up for that.
ASD activities. March 14 is Pi Day. Come out to the quad for some fun activities to celebrate math. Things to remember. March 16, Senate meeting in the MP room. Students need to bring their ID for check-in.
March 18, Powder Puff in the stadium from 5 to 9.
March 21st, prom tickets go on sale and there's prom meeting at lunch in the ASB room, 801. Here's the interview with Mrs. Bradwin.
My name is Carob Bradwin. I teach ceramics. This is my sixth year at Yuba City High School. Right now, my beginning students are making rain sticks, which are super fun. They like tip up and down and they sound like a waterfall. And then my advanced students were making teapots, and we're almost done with the teapots, with teacups. And we're going to have a tea party when we're all done, so it's going to be fun. I get to play in the clay all day and teach my students how to play in the clay and make cool stuff, and that's awesome. I took my first ceramics class at Shasta High School in Reading from Mr. Babcock, and really, I fell in love with it right away, and it's always been with me since, ever since high school, Shasta High School in Reading. Go Wolves.
Honkers, don't forget to be Yuba Gold.
Genuine, organized leaders dedicated. And that was your Honker News. Have a great day, Honkers.